Good afternoon, traders. It's Bill Baruch with Blue Line Futures and it's your Midday Market Minute. Happy Monday. A lot going on today and a lot going on this week. First, the tariffs were implemented at 12:01 a.m. Eastern Time, $200 billion worth of Chinese goods, and China retaliated back with $60 billion of U.S. goods. So we're starting to see a little bit of softness here in the S&P. You know, last week, Friday was quadruple witching. You know, we started to say this market was overdone and it should come back in. It traded to a high basically on the open, the cash open on Friday, and before retreating. Now, it's not uncommon to see a melt up into quadruple witching, and it's not uncommon to see that relief back after quadruple witching. So the question is this more news-driven with the retreat here in the S&P, or is it something that was really set off by quad witching? So we're seeing the S&P lower right now and is testing into a major three-star support. We need to see a close below there today in order to encourage further selling. We're also eyeing a trend line just below 2,900. Look for that as well to bring support. So we're watching these are big levels here for the S&P. If they close below them, you'll get more selling. If we don't close below them, we'd imagine you start to see a bounce off of that and a further consolidation. Regardless, it does feel like the market is overdone up here. And then we look to the Fed on Wednesday. So you got to as well prepare for the Fed meeting. We're also not only watching the S&P, but the Russell 2000. Big support down here at 1700 to 1702. We need to get a firm move down below there. And the Russell could lead the way to the downside and encourage that bigger waves of selling, those bigger waves of selling that I was just talking about. Watch it. Be nimble in this market. Volatility should continue. Moving on to crude oil, we're melting higher right now. This is testing near $73. We have our next resistance level just below there, where it looks like we should be able to close a good, clear close out above 71.15. This is a bullish breakout, a bullish pennant breakout on the November only contract. The front month contracts, we've obviously seen about $75 this year, and there's going to be some resistance levels on the way up, right here just below 73 being one. Watch it, and then we do have inventory data coming up here throughout the week. Expectations should start to trickle out today. So be nimble as well in crude oil. The higher it goes, the higher the volatility should be. So remember that. And then lastly, we are seeing some pressure on the dollar. Comments coming from Draghi today. The gold has seen a firm bid from that. And then as well, we started to see the Treasury prices move up. Now they did turn south. This spike up really coincided with just a move, a weaker move in the S&P after the bell, as well as the Deputy Attorney General Rosenstein comments. Is he fired? Is he resigning? But then we also had comments from Secretary of State Pompeo about the American pastor in Turkey could be released. So you're starting to see the Treasuries tick down. A lot of conflicting news that are moving the markets. You want to stay nimble here today, and we are here to help with any questions. Give us a call, 312-278-0500. You can email us, info@bluelinefutures.com. Check our website for updates, and you can sign up for a free trial of our research there. But remember, futures trading involves substantial risk of loss. It's not suitable for all investors. Thank you.